very much for making time for the show.
Thank you.
Pleasure to host you here.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, you know, you've been a long timer at F-Secure, 13 years, and of which you spent 10 years with the management team. Mm. Tell me, what's really changed now in 2018 that has you excited?
I think first, this is it's a great industry. So to be at the market is growing, and F-Secure is performing really well. So, and I'm very happy with the direction how we managed to start expanding our portfolio. I think we carry deep roots in the endpoint protection. Mm-hmm. Some people would refer that as an antivirus industry. So,
that's a
great platform to build on. And then if you look at F-Secure offering today, we do so much more. So we've added detection capabilities, we are doing response, we are doing vulnerability management, we added cybersecurity services via a couple of acquisitions. So we do forensics, incident response, we do targeted threat simulations. So it's just an exciting portfolio to carry, and I think that's really what makes this a great industry to be at. So
interesting. You know, I've been following the company for a while, and it's been amazing how you've taken the company from just being primarily a telco and a consumer business to now a very significant enterprise business. So much so that it's been growing much stronger compared to the industry. So what do you think about that? Why has that turnaround been possible?
I think we made good choices for what comes, I think, the portfolio selection. We always kept very high integrity, so that the product needs to be of great quality. So
right.
I think eventually the customers, the channel partners appreciate that you always have a reputation to really build best-in-class products. So I think that's there definitely. And then the thing what you mentioned, I think our focus in the past really being on the telco community and harnessing them to protect their customers with F-Secure products. So we definitely continue being very committed to that, but we also see perhaps better growth opportunities on B2B side with the enterprises. So that's the industrial logic that drives F-Secure today.
Makes sense. But tell me, you know, right now your B2B business is primarily on the mid-market.
Yep.
How do you really plan to take that to the large enterprises? Because ultimately that's where the big monies are. And of course, bigger sales cycles as well and bigger pains as well. But you know, that's where the bigger monies is.
Yeah.
So what are the plans?
Well, I think it also a little bit depends on the definition. So how we see mid-market, it's actually not, we expand that to companies that are with thousands of employees. So some other companies would call that already kind of an enterprise play. But we actually think that the mid-market is often a little bit underserved,
okay.
and we want to develop our tools, the products, so that they genuinely are enterprise grade
right.
for what comes to capabilities.
Right.
But we think that for what comes to go to market model, it's the mid market that actually makes a lot of sense for F-Secure, and we think that that it's really an underserved market and a great market opportunity. So I think we even today we could be focusing on enterprises because we really want to be making the product so that they would meet the criteria even for the most demanding enterprises.
Okay.
But it's more of a go-to-market choice.
Okay.
And that's why we also call our strategy like an enterprise-grade cybersecurity for mid-market. Yeah.
So if you were to identify 2 to 3 things that have really worked for you in the B2B space, what would those be?
I think if I look at 2017, so we started to sell our rapid detection service, which
right.
kind of is in this managed detection market. So that is really taking off really, really well. So, and we've had many great competitor replacements. So when customers have our product in place, and then they have some other vendors with competing technologies, and then they have a third party conducting a targeted attack simulation or red teaming, if you will. We've just seen so many times that the competitor's product, they don't detect these attacks, and we do.
Right.
And right there, it's an obvious choice for customers. So who do you go for? So I think that's definitely one. The second is that it's really the partner-led business model, so that we are very committed on channel. We are really doing everything with the channel orientation for what comes to business planning, and
okay.
and it also goes to the product design.
Right.
Because we want to design the products in a way that we would enable service business opportunities to our channel partners. And that, I think, is also a change that I see in the marketplace. So not just the traditional resellers who are quote-unquote just reselling, but really focusing, working with those partners who are more like service-oriented and who are building their own set of services on top of the products that they get from F-Secure. So I think that's an interesting kind of market dynamics.
Interesting. And you know, the cybersecurity landscape is increasing by the day, really. There's so many small nuggets of changes which are coming in. How are you using mergers and acquisitions as a route to be able to fulfill those gaps in your product portfolio, if you may?
It's a great question. The last year and a half, we've been very vocal to the investor community
yeah.
that we really see M&A as an integral part of F-Secure growth strategy.
Mm-hmm.
So we've been looking at M&A a lot. So last year and a half, 2 years, we've done three M&A or three acquisitions. And we have a lot of money in the bank to our size of a company. F-Secure is currently debt-free. So I think we could be leveraging the company much more. So absolutely, M&A is very important. That's something that where I'm also spending a lot of time myself. Just finding the right targets is not easy. I think you could very easily go and buy this company and buy this company, but then would the overall story still make sense? Would that really fit technology-wise? And often I think with M&A, the challenge is that is there a cultural fit with the people? So finding the companies that would be a great fit for F-Secure, finding the companies that we could make them better in our hands, it's not very easy to find those targets.
I couldn't agree more with you. You know, I remember back in time when Oracle acquired Sun, it was a software company acquiring a hardware company,
yeah.
and it was a total nightmare, right? The RFPs cycles wouldn't match, the sales cycles wouldn't match. And you know, it was a real nightmare situation. So you know, you guys acquired NSense last year. Can you give us a sense of how's that business shaped up post acquisition?
Yeah, so we're super happy how things have gone, and I think it's a great showcase how the cultural fit really was there. So F-Secure, we've always been a very much, I would say, an engineering led company. So very strong culture in technology. So not always as good in marketing as some of our competitors might be.
Sure.
So some people may every once in a while even refer F-Secure as the best kept secret in our industry. But anyways, I think that's one piece. So that the cultural fit was really there. So instance, they really had a super strong expertise
okay.
in areas like forensics, incident response,
okay.
and so forth. So.
Okay.
So that's one piece. The second is that we see that the cybersecurity consulting is very adjacent to product business.
Right.
Because when we do gigs in incident response and when we do forensics, we get to learn about cyber attacks that nobody has never ever seen before. Sometimes these most advanced attacks are polymorphic. They are using unthinkable techniques. The attacks are fireless. So by providing these forensics and incident response service to our customers, additional to products, we get to transfer that threat insights to our products. And we see that this really is a winning combination, that you have the world-class experts and the best technology. And I think with NSense acquisition, that really kind of laid the foundation of that, how services can be complementary and adjacent to product business.
Very interesting. And what does digital assurance bring to F-Secure?
It's very similar play actually as NSense was. So NSense gave us the footprint and the market access in cybersecurity consulting predominantly in the North Europe or in the Nordics. And now digital assurance is following that path. So we wanted to expand our services capabilities in UK, and they have a good presence in UK, so
okay.
it's more like adding to what we already started with NSense.
Excellent. You know, you spoke about cybersecurity multiple times over the last 5-7 minutes. You know, being a champion in cybersecurity also requires getting new skill sets inside the company. Of course, one way is M&A, which you guys are focusing on very heavily. But are you going out there and picking up new talent at all?
Oh, absolutely. And this is so difficult. I think that this industry is witnessing a massive talent shortage. So I think last year, 2017, we hired plus 200 people, and we would have definitely hired much more if there were the skills available. So it's very important. One example that we are doing, as an example, we started this cybersecurity course with the Helsinki Technical University, and we thought that hey, this probably would be interesting to students, and we thought that we would have some hundreds of people applying. And the minute we announced that cybersecurity course with the university, we had more than 5,000 people applying that. And of course, then we want to be utilizing those sorts of arenas as a hiring platform.
That's right. And it's very critical to run the business long term as well.
Yes.
Right? Wonderful. Let's talk about emerging markets. Everyone sort of talks about it. Give me a sense of how's the emerging markets been for F-Secure? And within the emerging markets as well, which are those pockets that you really think is working for you folks?
Well, currently, if I look at the emerging markets, so India, to name one, is really a market that was one of our fastest growing markets last year. So I'm very happy how things have developed in India.
Right.
Another very strong market in the past for F-Secure has been Latin America.
Okay.
So we've had great success in Brazil with some of the local big telcos in consumer space. And so I think those are the two that come to my mind immediately. So
okay, interesting. And you know, the fact is, when you start introducing a lot of these cybersecurity assessment services and partners being a very large base of your seller base, right? How do you really take these new age services to these partners? How do you really reskill them? Because it's inevitable that they are the ones who make you successful in the end.
Absolutely. And I think it's very important that you are segmenting the market. So not only segmenting the end customers, as we talked about earlier. So you have consumers, you have small companies, you have mid-market, you have enterprise. But equally, you need to be segmenting the partners, because you have those partners who are really well-equipped to carry these services. Some partners are not quite here there yet, but they want to be moving there, that they just need help, they need encouragement. And then you have some partners who are like very, very advanced, like in really as a security service providers by trade.
Right.
And then lastly, you have those partners who are not into building any service business, they are just reselling. So we also try to now segment our partner base and really fine-tune the F-Secure approach according to the channel. Yeah.
And if I was to ask Samu, the CEO for F-Secure, three key things that he believes will happen for F-Secure in 2018, what will those three things be?
Well, first, we absolutely will continue growing.
Okay.
I strongly believe that we not grow only, but we grow faster than the market. I think that's a true measure of your competitiveness. If you are outpacing the market, it means that you win market share.
Do you have a range in mind?
No. no range. The second is that as we've been very actively looking at M&A, so I'd expect something happening on that front.
Okay.
And that's obviously an area where you can never ever disclose anything.
Of course.
So that wasn't the pre-announcement of any M&A activity. It's more kind of an aspiration.
I understand.
And I think the third is that we really are very enthusiastic about announcing our EDR product this spring to really complement the endpoint protection. So I think these would be the three big things. So continue growing, pushing for M&A, and EDR launch. These are three major cornerstones for F-Secure.
Sounds like a fantastic plan, Samu.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for taking time.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for watching.